Swoosh. Just do it. My sneakerheads or sneaker enthusiasts out there, there's something you have to understand. The Air Force One is more than just a shoe. That was the assumption in the early 1980s when I was born back in 82, since its inception on the exact year that I was born. So when Bill Bowerman and Phil Knight founded Nike in 1964, they had no idea that the Air Force One would be the Air Force One you see on everyone's feet. This was way before Swoosh and Just Do It became billionaire trademarks across the globe. The Air Force One ended up becoming a trademark of its own. Now, the shoe was produced on my year birth, 1982, but unfortunately was discontinued in 1984. Now, 2 years later, they were re-released, more refined, and better suited for quintessential hooper or fashion geeks. Now, subsequently, NBA players took the trend and mixed it with their own flavor. And we're talking about Moses Malone from the Philadelphia 76ers, Michael Thompson from Portland Trailblazers, Los Angeles Lakers player Jamal Wilkes, Calvin Knapp from the Portland Trailblazers, Bobby Jones from Philadelphia 76ers, and Michael Cooper from the Los Angeles Lakers. Also, let's not forget, Jerry Stackhouse and Rasheed Wallace wore them as well. The high tops were more popular during the 1990s. Players back then were satisfied with the comfort of the shoe, but there's no comfort without architecture, which of course, Bruce Kilgore being the architect and mastermind behind the idea, creating the Air Force One with Nike Air technology. Now, there's more information I can read into this, folks, but I'm not gonna hit you with too much information. I'll just say this before I go to the review. You really have to think back into what was really created when Air Force Ones was put on feet, even down to the actual design work of the blueprint when Kilgore was drawing out the shoe and creating it in his mind. It's more than a shoe at this point. It's similar to the popular of Air Jordan 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 retro, whatever you want to call it, Jordan retros and period. It is very popular. It's one of those shoes that have you standing in line waiting for hours. You know, I gotta have them. I gotta cop that. You know that's true for sneakerheads, sneaker enthusiasts, whatever the case, but it's a lifelong trend. It's a lifelong style that's been emboldened with the fashion culture. Let's get into the review real quick. Hello, everyone on YouTube. This is Tykees, and salutations to you, to all my family, friends, folks watching this video. Appreciate your support and watching the video. Hey, make sure to like and share. If you're with subscribers, we'll naturally come on board. Let's not worry about that right now. Just trying to get the love of the shoe from me to you. And today we are going to be going to another retail shoe. That is right. Now we'll go into where I got them from, but first, let's get into these shoes right here, which we are looking at, yes, Nike Air Force One Type 1. Let's get started. All right, so let's get into it real quick. We got the box right here. Zoom out a little bit. In fact, let's move the camera back some. Yeah, there we go. Give it some space, you know, get that straightened right there. That's right, no cuts, no edits, folks. We're going right into it the way we should. All right, so we got the box here. Showing y'all that. We got the box right here. Air Force One Type Black Gum, not Lack Foam. I don't know what I was about to say. Sorry about that. Anthracite, gum light brown, size 12, of course, 13 and a half women's. Yes, this box was made in China. The label was made in China. I mean, everything was made in China, honestly, so let's keep it a buck. But anyway, not trying to go into a tie-way today, just showing y'all the swoosh and all that in the back. So that's what's up. Of course, you got the other signs here. Nike here. Nike swoosh right here. Just do it on them. Nike back here. Just in case you don't remember what, you know, company you brought this from. And show the rest of the box here. Let's read it here. Champions Nike's legacy of experimentation and innovation. An unapologetic exploration to push the boundaries of design. N.354 is not trend. N.354 is not conservative. N.354 is not scared. Established 2 years ago in Beaverton, Oregon. Hey, that's what's up. I'm glad y'all are not scared to make sure that the prices keep going up on your main brand, Jordan brand shoes. But hey, we're not here to talk about that. Oh, no, no, no. We're here to talk about this, which Air Force Ones have become so affordable that why even get them from overseas? So just get them here in the good old USA. All right. Now, before we get into the shoe, I know you're like, wait a second, where's the shoe going? Yeah, hold on. Hold tight. Let me just get the shoes out of the box right quick. Let me show y'all the main thing that you're probably gonna be asking about. So yes, here's the 2021 tag for GOAT verification. I'm just gonna scroll it up like on some Star Wars stuff here. On, oh, it's too close. Here we go. Color, shape, all the stuff that you see. Quality control, accessories. Oh, now the camera's going in and out. Come on, camera, stop doing that to me. Okay. And then we got the GOAT sticker in the background. Here you go. Just in case you want to slap it on your favorite retail box or resale box. Now, let's get into the shoe itself. Look at that. Look at that. Now, these shoes right here are part of Nike's conceptual N.354 series that reimagines the iconic silhouette. The Nike Air Force One low type is defined by its deconstructed makeover with transparent materials, prominent for its unique closure system and the translucent materials. As we're talking about, of course, the ripstop material, the muslin material that I love on all shoes. This is like I, this is my shoe right here, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is my first pair of Air Force Ones, besides what you saw in the beginning of the picture. Wow, what is it, the 1930s? In the beginning of the video, you saw my first Nike ID created Air Force One mids. Or they could have been highs. I think they were highs or mids. I don't know. You tell me. Anyway, nonetheless, they were Air Force One based. But they also had a like a lunar boot, a duck lunar boot type hybrid to them, as you can see on the bottom section and the actual, you know, front, the toe box of the shoe itself, the mud guard. All of that was more of like a lunar boot that Nike's been coming out with as far as the duck boots. But yeah. Definitely see the translucent material here, the ripstop material, muslin material, whatever you want to call it. And then you have here an adjustable strap on the heel and bearing handwritten like N.354 branding on the sides, in addition to the visible stitching sideways, or excuse me, stitching details. Let's take a look at this right here. There we go. So y'all see that? You're probably asking, Takisa, what's that for? I don't know. I mean, when you, I'm gonna show it again, the strap part again on feet, but I mean, it's really, I guess, to hold your ankle more securely, but these are pretty snug on foot, so I don't know. But this is my favorite part right here. This reminds me of like a Goodyear tire or something. I mean, look at this mud guard right here. Like, ah, damn, now this will definitely protect against mud. Like, usually, like, okay, the mud guard, okay, that's what they call the shoe, but no, this, and then the material, yo, you know what this reminds me of, y'all? Like a Batman outfit, you know what I'm saying? Like, the last Batman that came out, not the newest Batman coming out with Robert Pattinson, I'm talking about the one with Ben Affleck, where his suit was, like, grayish dark. That's what this material reminds me of. I mean, just look how it looks, this leather, man, like, sheesh. And then the midsole is, like, a little off dark black or whatever. You got your Air right there, of course, because it's Air Force One. And then you got your Air Force One bottom, Nike right there, gum sole, really sets it off. Yeah, this is nice. Definitely a nice shoe. Let's look at the tongue right quick. Tongue is nice and soft. Type of mesh on the tongue there. Let's put this right here right quick, see if there's any more to read. That's right. Now, this new colorway of the model comes dressed in black anthracite, which is what this is, black here, anthracite up here, and gum light brown color scheme. It's basically a black upper place on top of a gum roll, excuse me, gum upper outsole. Now, these were retailing for $140, count them $140, but I got them for, yes, $96. Here's the tag here that comes with the shoe. Captures the innovating nature of Nike while creating a place to test ideas. Collection explores fit, comfort, and rethinks convention from the inside out. Risk and stress, FTW. Yes, I am happy to have purchased this pair of shoes. Would you like to see the other one? Sure, why not? Let's switch it out. Yeah, man. Not too much of a rock here, so that's good. Good stability overall. Let's do the quick durable test. Oh shit. Oh shit. Look at the hand shaking. Look at the hand shaking. Yeah, this shit is durable, bro. Like, ma'am, if you're watching this for your husband's late Valentine's gift, a female watching this, because the analytics says that no females are watching this, but hey, you never know, right? If y'all are watching this, definitely, yeah, this would be a good shoe to get, because right now it's not selling for much. You know what I mean? So it's definitely below retail, so yeah, snatch these up before they're out. And I got these from no other than, that's right, you see right there on the screen. Now, y'all are probably thinking, but Takisa, didn't you say that it's a leap of faith for getting these shoes, thinking they're retail? Yes, it is a leap of faith. But it's a leap I'm willing to take nonetheless, and I'm not stressed over it. It's no point to be stressed, people. Here's the Nike swoosh right here if you didn't catch it before. And then you got your sole, which, let me flip around, based on a prototype from 2001. Nike Air Moab, I think it says. And then I think the tag is in here, so let's show the tag real quick. Uh-oh. Here's the tag. Hold it, pause it. Pause it, and done. All right. So yes, this is the N.354. Let's get the shoehorn out of there, like so, and yeah. I'm liking this shoe, y'all, I really am. I'm glad I purchased it, and I'm glad it's in my collection. And let's get to the end of the video. All right, so yeah, that's the Nike Air Force One Type 1. First official pair of shoes that were created by a designer that was originally hired by Nike. So my first Air Force Ones I showed you already in the last part of the video, or in the beginning for part of the video. That was my first pair of Air Force Ones that I created for myself. But I'm really happy with these. When I first saw them, I knew I had to have them. So this has been Takisa. Hey, questions, comments, concerns, hit me up right here. Information above my head as usual. Let's go ahead and get onto that on the feed, and then we'll move on to the next review, whatever that is, and go from there. I have an idea of what I might review next, but you know, it's always nice to keep it a surprise, right? Take care.
Feel that way. Feel that way. Feel that way. I can feel that way.
Up and early for the hope of a brand new day. See a homie you ain't seen since back in the day. Fresh haircut fitted with a fat ass fade. Into work week chilling on a Saturday. How you felt when you first heard the daddy came? Rocky MKRS, hey, I had that day. Cooling out with old girl on a fat ass day. Find $100 bill, wow man, that's great. Get promoted at your job up to management. Plot a long time, finally your plan is made. In time I feel I wanna shout, man, it's real that way. When I think of things that make you feel that way.
Make you feel that way. Make you feel that way. 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 Feel that way.
Christmas Day when your mama got your first bite. Type of feeling when you went and won your first fight. How your team felt winning championship games. Celebrate in a huddle, dancing in this rain. Have a thought, see a shooting star across your screen. Put in hard work, finally you're living your dream. Deaf man get his hearing, now income vibes. Blind man gaining sight, see his first sunrise. Dumb man speaking out, now he's loud and clear. Birth of your child, smile so proud you wear. Going in your third eye, the nostalgia here. Making music that'll bump for 1,000 years. Eating right, feeling conscious like health is first. Said a prayer that's sincere when you felt it work. Times I feel I wanna shout, man, it's real that way. When I think of things that make you feel that way.